There's so much information available on the internet that sometimes it can be hard for people to interpret everything that they get. I'm a firm believer in spending all the time that's necessary in order for our patients and their families to fully understand what's going on to make a good decision.
Hi, Max Brantley with the Arkansas Times on Friday, January the 26th. Well, the news today begins with Donald Trump. Late last night, the New York Times reported that it had confirmed, and even Fox News had to admit it was true, that Donald Trump had apparently threatened some time ago to fire Robert Mueller as a special counsel, but his White House counsel refused to do it, said it would be a disaster, so he backed off. I just ask you to imagine for a minute if such a story had appeared about Bill Clinton or Barack Obama, what the reaction would have been. Donald Trump simply calls it fake news, and we move on. On immigration, Donald Trump is setting a tone that Senator Tom Cotton in Arkansas is repeating, and that is that they really want to help the Dreamers, those kids who came to the U.S. as immigrants with parents through no fault of their own, and they've known only the U.S. as their country. Well, they're for them as long as they can get in the bargain a lot of other punitive immigration measures, a great reduction in the number of people admitted to the country, and into a lottery to help people in deprived countries, throwing out people who are not direct family members, other things such as that. Democrats say that's a non-starter. Will they succeed with this? Tom Cotton is using children as hostages in this negotiation. Make no sense, make no mistake about that. There's news today on the Me Too front, the continuing stories about sexual harassment and assault. The two big stories are these. One, the Wall Street Journal has a deep story about the number of times Steve Wynn, the casino mogul and Republican National Committee finance chairman, has been accused of sexual assault, paid big judgments. A lot of people say he's a real sexual predator. The other story is that somebody who worked for Hillary Clinton's campaign in 2008 was accused of sexual harassment, and the campaign had a process in place. They suspended him, they docked his pay, they counseled him, they put the woman and him in different jobs, but he was not fired, and he later in another job related to the campaign harassed again and then was fired. Well, which story do you think is going to get more traction out of Fox News, Steve Wynn or this guy 9 years ago now in the Hillary Clinton campaign? I think we know the answer to that. I should add the Republican Party demanded that the Democratic Party refund all money raised by Harvey Weinstein, the sexual predator of some notoriety. I don't think they'll be asking Steve Wynn to return any money he raised for their party. Interesting new database about the Consumer Financial Protection Bureau. It shows the number of settlements in each state that have affected people here. In Arkansas alone, there have been 91 cases where thousands of people have gotten millions of dollars back from work against payday lenders, credit card abusers, mortgage services, and the like. This is the outfit that the Trump administration hopes to wither and eventually shut down. Interesting news, too, in Missouri, the Satanic Temple, which is planning to sue in Arkansas, the Ten Commandments Monument, it's a very serious religious and civil freedoms organization, is making some headway against anti-abortion laws in Missouri. They forced the government there to admit that they cannot force women to undergo an ultrasound and to receive the tests of those ultrasound, not if a woman says she has a religious objection to it. This could provide a pathway in Arkansas to people to raise, yes, the Religious Freedom Protection Act against laws that make things, people do things that are contrary to their religion. Some people see abortion as a religious issue. Those who are against it certainly do. Those who see a right to it have religious interpretations as well. In Missouri, they're making headway on that front. Yesterday, Attorney General Leslie Rutledge turned down the first try at a ballot title for an amendment that would allow three casinos in Arkansas and use some of the money from those casinos to finance highways. She says that the mention of highways in the title, although the amendment certainly does that, might mislead people into what this amendment's really about. Well, yes, it's about casinos. It's also about highway funding. This reminds that some of this is about who writes the titles. When the legislature wrote a title of an amendment that talked about term limits and actually extended the term limits, they let that on the ballot even though it was grossly misleading. We can expect Leslie Rutledge, who's a tool of the business establishment, to resist the casino amendment because the business establishment wants to protect Oaklawn Park and Southland Park, the two monopoly casinos that currently exist in Arkansas. A bow towards Central Arkansas yesterday from the University of Arkansas at Fayetteville. The Hogs are going to play their spring football game at War Memorial Stadium, as well as one SEC game in the fall against Ole Miss. This is to try and renew some ties with a part of the state that once used to be crucial to Razorback football financial success. but has become less so as the balance of financial power has shifted to the northwest Arkansas portion of the state. And finally, this note. I reported yesterday that a animal rights activist had protested that the National Guard had rented armories to a circus that had an elephant show. The National Guard then canceled most of those shows. PETA, the animal rights organization that most people in Arkansas love to hate for its aggressive animal rights activities, says it's going to send a reward to the Arkansas National Guard for looking out for the elephants, a box of vegan elephant-shaped cookies. I'm for that. Send one to me and keep resisting. I'm Max Brantley. I'll be back next week.